all set? Live?
Not yet, I'll come back.
Name of the Lord.
Name of the Lord.
us up from within us, for we ask this in Jesus' name, and everybody say it.
Amen.
Louder than the under.
On my ear, the Son of God.
experience that the Lord has an individual, personal relationship with each one of us, different from each one of us, that only we can know. That only, isn't that awesome? That only we can know. That blows my mind. Okay, I shall have my
Jesus. Thank you. worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Holy, holy.
Thank you. worship you, my God. I love to worship you, my Lord, and see your Spirit fall in power, your love unfolding, gifts from heaven. I love to worship you, my God.
House. Amen. Praise
you,
Jesus.
Lord, amen.
We're going to receive your tithes and offerings this morning as our brother. Blessed the Lord. Brother Todd, would you ask God's blessing on our offering today? Ask your blessing upon your word this morning, that it would touch our hearts and touch our lives and minister to us in a special way. And everybody said amen. Stages of God's mind, God Almighty. He knew that man would need a sacrificial lamb to conquer the sin and death that man would allow to come because of his free will, to come into the world by his poor choices. Have you ever made a poor choice in your life? More than a few, I think. I have a hard time getting throughout a whole day without a poor choice. All right? But God knows all things. He knows all things. He sees all things. He hears all things. And time is but a village in his mind. You know, time is but a village in his mind. He sees the whole outlay of time. Therefore, even as we are made in the triune image of God, body, soul, and spirit. Body, soul, and spirit. So God fashioned himself a body and put his spirit in it and sent it to earth, his Holy Spirit. And his voice spoke creation as the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters, what would become our planet. The Spirit of God later visited Mary, and the creation of God in the flesh was made, that he was spoken of since the foundation of the world. The Lamb of God had come. For certain immutable laws, that means laws that cannot be broken, laws of the universe that were made from the very before the very foundation of God, that wrong should be punished, that wrong should be disciplined, that wrong should be paid for. But as God looked upon time, as he looked upon time, Isaiah, the prophet Isaiah said in chapter 63, verse 5, God looked upon time and I looked, this is God speaking, and I looked and there was none to help.
He looked upon time. He looked over all of time. And he saw that there was none to help. And I wondered that there was none to uphold. In other words, that there was no righteous person to pay the price for the sins of men. Then he says this, therefore, my own arm will bring salvation. Now, my Muslim brothers, are you getting this? For you do not always understand the oneness of God. Or the oneness of man, for that matter. Neither have you understood to now that the Lamb of God had to be sacrificed. Jesus had to be sacrificed. They don't believe that he was sacrificed. They don't believe he died for our sins. But God had to come in the flesh because he had to pay the price himself, for there was none who could. Because it was an immutable law, a law that could not be changed. So he planned to die for our sins from before time existed. Before it existed, he was willing to pay the price for our poor choices. First Peter makes it very clear in chapter 1, verses 18 to 21. For as much as you know that you were not redeemed by corruptible things, you were paid for with silver or gold. That your vain conversation from the traditions of your fathers would tell you that that's good enough. That's good enough. Earthly things are good enough. The blood of a sacrificial lamb or the slaughter of animals, all those things. They can't buy your way into heaven. But you were redeemed with the precious blood of Jesus Christ as a lamb without blemish or without spot, who verily was foreordained before the foundation of the world, but was manifest in this last time just for you. And even as Abraham, the father of faith, was spoken to by an angel, and the angel said to him, God has provided himself a sacrifice. The lamb has been a symbol of these sacrifices for sin, all the way back to Abel, as Abel's sacrifice pictured what would happen. So it's amazing that the Holy Spirit must have spoke to Abel's heart and said, you're going to sacrifice to God. Bring a lamb, because that's a symbol of what I'm going to do for you. And you'll feel what I feel with that loss of that lamb. Wow. As Isaiah prophesied in chapter 53, who has believed? Have you believed it? Have you even heard it? To whom has the arm of the Lord revealed it to? For I sent him to the earth, and he grew up like a young plant, and he had no form or majesty that you would think anything of him. There was no beauty in him that you should desire him. In other words, Jesus divested himself of majesty and became an unseemly man. And he was despised and rejected by men. A man of sorrows and acquainted with our griefs. Acquainted with our griefs, as it says in Hebrews chapter 1:15. We don't have someone as God that does not understand our circumstances. But was in all points tempted such as we are, yet without fault, without sin, without wrongdoing. In other words, he went through all of our worldly tribulations, yet he did not sin in any point. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised, but for our iniquities, the wrong things that we had done, the chastisement for our peace with God was laid upon him. And by his stripes, our body, soul, and spirit can be healed. And he was brought as a lamb to the slaughter. Did you hear that? Yet it pleased the Lord to bruise him. Then you shall make his soul an offering for sin. That's a prophecy of Isaiah about our Lord and Savior. Hundreds and hundreds of years before Jesus. Now often this question is asked, how could the Father do this to his Son? Or how could God do that to good and faithful prophet, as our Islam brothers believe? But you see, the word of God does not stop with the sacrifice, with just him paying for our sins. For Christ was not only come to bring redemption, but to bring victory over death. And his seed of faith, the seed planted in us that brings forth new life, his Holy Spirit seed. So to Christ, victory over death and his rising on the third day is just the first fruits of all them who believe that he paid the price for us. So sing, O ye barren, Isaiah goes on to say, sing, O ye barren that did not get to bear children in the flesh, but you shall have even more children in the spirit. So through Jesus, although he did not marry, yet he has children, many millions and billions of children. Hallelujah. That he has promised resurrection from the dead and everlasting life too. And he says, behold, I stand at the door of your heart and I knock. And if any man hear my voice and open his door, the door to your spirit, and allow his Holy Spirit to come in, you shall be changed. And that door, behold, a door was opened in heaven. And a voice as a trump said, come up. Whew. Hallelujah. And we're in the book of Revelations. And John is seeing what must happen. And the first thing that he sees, an angel saying, who is worthy? Who is worthy to open the book and to loose the seals thereof? And I beheld, and lo, in the midst of the throne stood a lamb, as it has been slain. And the lamb came, and he took the book right out of the hand of him that sat on the throne. And all fell before the lamb, because you only bow before God, singing, thou art worthy to take the book, to open the seals thereof. For you were slain and have redeemed us by your blood out of every kindred and every tongue and every people and every nation. And all of them sang with a loud voice, worthy is the Lamb that was slain to receive power and riches and wisdom and strength and honor and glory and blessing. And then the great tribulation takes place, which is meant to sift the saints from the ants and to confine evil at the end for 1,000 years, so that men want another test, 1,000 years, without being able to say, the devil made me do it. 1,000 years to serve God without that excuse. In this great tribulation, which Matthew says in Matthew 24, will be unmatched from the beginning of the world till now. Just think of that. They were saying that during the Roman persecution and killing of millions and millions of people and the devastation that had taken place. And think of all the earthquakes, the Black Plague, the Spanish flu, the Holocaust, the world wars, the gas germ warfare, all the different things, the famines that have happened throughout the world. This will be all of those combined together and worse. And God is wanting, be ready. For the opening of that celestial door is but a flash in time. Just a flash in time. Just a flash in time, and then it will close. And for the righteous, it's open for salvation and everlasting life. But for the wicked, tribulation and ruin and death. But the time for choosing, this time choose wisely, all right? This time choose rightly. The time for choosing sides is now. Are you with God or against him? Do you accept his sacrifice for your sin? Or do you want to die in your sin? The choice is yours. Amen. Look, Lord, we just come before you. We thank you that you saw throughout time that there would be no one worthy. And you chose to do it yourself and come as Jesus Christ in the flesh. And you walked among us, and now we have no longer got that excuse that when we go to heaven, but God, you don't know the pain and the tribulation it is. It's not like it is up here in heaven. Well, it's not like that down there. Lord, you don't know. We can't say that anymore because he does know. We don't have that excuse. That excuse is God. He paid the price for our sin. He paid the price of that immutable law that had to be kept. And he did it for you, and he did it for me. And he said, all those who believe that this is what I've done for you, this door is going to open. Are you going to come? And pray for you right now that you would say yes to that sacrifice, that you would say yes. Now I understand. He isn't dead. He's alive. He's God on the throne. And he someday will come to judge the living and the dead. No matter when he comes in my life, I need to be ready. I need to be ready now. And I believe you paid the price for me. And I open the door to my heart. And I ask him by his Holy Spirit to come into my human spirit, to wash and cleanse my sin away, body, soul, and spirit, wash me clean, that I might live for him now and live with him for all eternity. For I ask this in Jesus' name. And everyone who agrees said, amen. 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 Okay. We're going to receive communion at this time. And if you have not gotten your communion, maybe it came in something. Make sure you let somebody know. Lord, we thank you for this emblem of your suffering and death for us. It's unleavened bread because you were without sin. You made no wrong choices. And he said, remember that I paid the price. Remember this. Remember, I am the Passover lamb. I paid the price for your deliverance. I paid the price for your redemption. I paid the price for you. We thank you for paying the price for us, Lord. Let us partake together. And they overcame by the word of their testimony and by the blood of the Lamb. We thank you for the symbol of your blood and this fruit of the vine. We ask you, Lord God, to bless it, that you would wash and cleanse us from all the debris of sin on this earth. But we ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's partake together. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
What you have sent him from your side to walk upon this guilty song and to be give the love. Jesus, no turning.